Did you know that bone growth usually peaks around the age of 35, and there's something that you can do about it? So come along with me and I'll show you. So walking is one of the best ways and easiest ways to begin building bone growth for your lower body. Things you want to think about is standing tall. Pretend you're 2 inches taller than you are. You want to have a comfortable stride length when you're walking. It's an open chain activity, so your leg is coming off a surface, hitting a surface, so you're getting forces transmitted up through the body, and that's going to stimulate that bone growth. You can do steps, and we'll demonstrate some for you. Going forwards and backwards, stepping forward, stepping back. Easy way to get that bone stimulation. You can go side to side, out and back. Real simple to do. You don't need a lot of space. You can make boxes, so you can go forward, forward, and back. Again, another simple, easy step you can do. You can make circles. So you're stepping out and around. There you go. Good. So just making circles like this, so you're getting those forces transmitted up through your legs at different angles to stimulate the bone growth around your body. So if you want a higher level challenge for building your strength and for your bone growth, you can do things like squats and lunges. So there are different ways to modify it. I'm going to demonstrate a deep squat, and then I'll have Kay demonstrate a modified squat. So deep squat, you go down and you come up. Things that are really important to remember is you want to keep your feet facing forward, knees lined up with your feet, but you want to be able to see your toes when you go down. So you can act like you wanted to sit down and come back up. To modify that, you just don't go down as far. So keep your knees separated. Act like you're going to do a little mini, so you're sitting onto a high stool instead of a low chair. So that's how you can modify it. If you feel unsafe, you can hold on to a chair or the back of the sofa or the countertop. Another thing that you can do is some lunges. Taking one leg, you step back. To modify it, you just do a little mini lunge, come back up together. You go back, down, together. To get deeper, I'll demonstrate that. You go back, you drop down, you come up. Keep your upper body straight. You don't want to be leaning forward. And those are different ways that you can challenge yourself at higher level activities. We want to keep the whole body strong. So different ways to do that are to use resistive bands or weights or even household activities. First I'm going to show you some things that you can do with a band. So you have your band up, you're going to bring your arms all the way out to the side and then back in, nice and slow and controlled. Pretend that you are 2 inches taller than you are, so you have nice good posture. I'm going to have Kay turn around here, and we're going to show you from the back. So something we want to focus on even a little bit more for me, turning around. So you want to think about squeezing your shoulder blades together and then letting them come forward. And the reason that is important, turn back around, is that when you think about postural changes, people start to come forward, and we want to avoid that. No one wants to look like this when they're walking around. So when you're pulling your shoulder blades together, that's going to help the bone growth back there, the muscle strength to keep you in better alignment. A couple of other things that you can do with your band is something called a sash or a seatbelt. So one arm will stay down, the other arm's up. You're going to pull it up across you, and the band's going to come across you like a seatbelt. Perfect. And then up and down. And then you always want to switch sides so you're not out of balance. So that's another simple thing you can do. You can use everyday household items to do your exercise also, especially for the upper body. We're going to do some water bottles. You can use cleaning supplies, you could be lifting and moving laundry baskets, anything around your house. Some easy things to do with the water bottles is overhead presses, just pressing up and down. So you're going to be building shoulder strength, those muscles will be getting stronger, pulling on the bones to create that bone growth. You can do bicep curls with them, arms by the side, you're just curling up and down. Going to work the front of the arms, get that strength in the muscles going. Another one you can do with these is tricep extension. So hands are up, and you're just straightening that elbow and bringing them back down. Easy to do these on commercial breaks during TV shows. You can do them while you're meal prepping. You can do them different times during the day. So we have open chain activities for the arms, which is where your hands can leave a surface and then come back to a surface, and then the closed chain activity for the arms and upper body strengthening, where you're holding weights or bands. We're going to demonstrate a little bit of both of those this time. So we're going to have Kay put her hands up on the wall. We're going to demonstrate doing a wall push-up. So she's just going to be coming close to the wall, pushing back out. You can do this on a wall, you can do this on a countertop. To make it into an open chain activity, she's going to push off the wall. So she's going to go in, she's going to push back. She's going to come forward and catch herself, slowly lower in. This is going to stimulate more bone growth because she's getting those forces through her arms. Thank you for taking time out of your busy schedule to spend with me and learn about osteoporosis and things that you can do to help build your bone. In summary, we talked about open-chained activity and closed-chained activity. The open-chained activity, there were the items like walking and dancing, those push-ups we did on the wall where you're springing off the wall. The closed-chained activity are going to be things like your squats and using your water bottles or the elastic bands so your limbs are staying in contact with something. If you would like to learn more information about our program, please visit our website at conehealth.com/osteoporosis. And my name is Sue Shaver.